Hi, everybody. I'm here today in sunny Phoenix, Arizona, and it is my great pleasure to be here with Dr. Nath and his patient, Virginia. And we're going to do some cord blood myth busting. In the past, we've always heard that cord blood is only for infants and children. But Virginia and Dr. Nath are here to dispel that fact, so I'm going to let them tell you their amazing story of Virginia's journey. Take it away.
Thank you. I was 81 years old when I was diagnosed with leukemia, and I talked with some people in the ER, and they said, well, if you have that diagnosis, there's really not much that can be done, but we're going to send you down to University of Massachusetts. There's a doctor there that you need to see. And that turned out to be Dr. Nath.
Yes, it was in 2013, and I remember it was the month of May, if I remember correctly. I was called to see Virginia Durgin in the ER, and I entered her room, and I could see a little old lady, which is what I would call her in the future. She was sitting there having a hard time breathing and was on a lot of oxygen. I had a quick look at her blood smear, and I knew she had acute leukemia. That time we did not know what kind of a leukemia it was. And 2 hours later, we got a blood test called flow cytometry, and she had acute myeloid leukemia. Talking to her, she said about a month ago, she was living alone and was doing everything, driving and all, and here she is requiring oxygen. And the question came up, what do we do now? And there were only a couple of options, and one was to treat or not to treat. And she decided she wanted treatment because the option not to treat was a certain death.
Right, and at that point I had grandchildren who were growing up, getting ready to go to college, and I had a little young grandchild. I wanted to see her grow up, and I just wasn't ready.
So we gave her chemotherapy, what is called induction chemotherapy, and within 12 hours when she started chemotherapy, she started to breathe better, and next morning I remember her seeing her in the morning. She was sitting down and having her breakfast. It was a different lady. Then started her journey, and she was in the hospital for a month, and in the end, we did a bone marrow biopsy, and we found that she was in complete remission. And then we started to ask where to next, and the question came up that the only cure would be a stem cell transplant, and that time generally would be from a fully matched donor, which would either be a sibling, which wasn't the case in her because her siblings were really old, or would be a fully matched unrelated donor. She unfortunately did not have a fully matched unrelated donor. Then we went to the cord blood registry, and we found that she had several potential cords that were not fully matched, but again, we do not need a fully matched cord to undergo a cord blood transplant.
And so I said, go ahead, let's do it.
She had some discussions. We went to and fro. We knew that there was certainly a 20 to 25% chance of dying from the procedure. And I shared with her that you're 80 plus. And I said, I've done several cord blood transplants, several transplants, but I've never done a cord blood transplant in somebody who's over the age of 80. And I can kill you. And she said, well, I want to take my best chance.
Yes. And I'm so glad I did.
And we made a decision after much discussion with the family members and all, and we did a transplant in August of 2013.
Right, August 12th.
And within 6 months, We took off all immunosuppressive medications after the transplant, and rest is history. And in July 2016, I moved from Massachusetts to Arizona, and I made her promise that every few months or in every anniversary, she'll be sending me a picture, and she's been doing that for all those
times. I like to send him pictures of me doing something, like I was swimming in the pool, or I was planting in a garden, and things that I do with my family. And I think those are the things that show how well our transplant worked.
It just tells to show us that there is life after stem cell transplant.
That certainly is.
You know, in the past, about 20 years ago, we would always be thinking that we don't want to replace one disease with another, the first disease being leukemia and the second disease being stem cell transplant, which gives rise to a lot of graft versus host disease and can make life miserable. Cord blood stem cell transplant, if it's successful, gives very little graft versus host disease, and people can come back to their life in a much shorter time frame.
And that's so good.
Yes. That's great. What a beautiful story at a second chance at life.
It certainly
and
was.
Thank you both so much for letting me film you, and just saying every cord we save can save a life, and you're never too young and you're never too old for cord blood transplant.
That's right.
So thank you both.
Thank you.